As all of you know, a few minutes ago, the grand jury deliberating the death of Michael Brown issued its decision. It's now come that either way was going to be subject of intense disagreement, not only in Ferguson, but across America. So I just want to say a few words suggesting how we might move forward. First and foremost, we are a nation built on the rule of law. So we need to accept that this decision was the grand jury's to make. There are Americans who agree with it, and there are Americans who are deeply disappointed.
Stores broken into and looted.
Tear gas has been thrown, water bottles we witnessed being thrown at police.
Tear gas.
Tear gas just dropped right near us. It's going to get very bad here if we don't have masks.
Yeah, so
they're throwing it back. There are a lot of beanbags being shown at tear gas.
What you're looking at is the aftermath of the grand jury deciding not to indict Officer Wilson.
That's one police cruiser
that is fully engulfed right now. And then if you just turn to your right, our photographer, Snake DeMoss, is going to get you the other cruiser. That one is almost finished burning.
It was mayhem. We saw these buildings catch on fire. This was a beauty supply store. And we watch it just burn to the ground.
The AutoZone is on fire. This is the third building within two blocks. And it is, you know, destroyed. The building is basically collapsed. You can hear the explosions going on inside there from whatever is inside, whether it's... Sorry, I just got hit by a rock. I've been hit much worse in my day. You're seeing the Title Max just up the street, right across, and that's another fire. And you're hearing the explosions from inside of some of those places.
Police, they've been working 12-hour shifts. So what they're doing now is sort of a shift change where they're coming back, and then other officers will be going out. Also, what you're looking at now on the other side of your screen, again, as we said at the top of this broadcast, we don't know what's